And welcome to our latest mini course on the applications of non-destructive testing for evaluation of defects in a concrete column. Before we begin, let's refresh our minds on concrete defects and their potential impact on the performance of a structural element. A defect is an unwanted condition that was not part of the original intent of design. Most famous forms of defects are cracking, subsurface voids, discontinuities such as delamination, and corroded steel rebar. Defects may or may not impact the performance of the structure. Some defects might only impact the structural integrity, while others impose durability concerns as well. As structural engineers, we are often asked to evaluate the existing condition of an element or a structure. To do so, engineers require information on the material properties, integrity of building materials, and the durability characteristics of those materials. Traditionally, we used to go to the job site with our core drilling machine and hammer drills to chip out some concrete and expose a steel rebar. Later, we measure the bar diameter, rebar spacing, and evaluate their condition. We took some cores from the concrete and perhaps cut some rebars in the process. However, there are certain occasions that we do not have that luxury anymore. Well-educated and tech-savvy asset owners are opting for less intrusive work day by day. And today, I'm going to show you how some of these technology-based solutions can help structural engineers in the process of structural evaluation. The first test method is GPR. Ground penetrating radar is a great method for scanning rebar location, rebar spacing, and estimating concrete cover thickness. The next method is the ultrasonic pulse echo tomography. UPE can be used to verify the thickness in concrete elements with one side access only. It can also be used to locate subsurface defects and identify potential integrity issues such as delaminations and voids. As simple as it is, Schmidt hammer can still provide useful information on the uniformity of concrete. Results can be used as a basis for comparing the quality of concrete at different locations. The results can also be incorporated into mathematical models to predict the compressive strength of concrete. Last but not least is the most famous ultrasonic pulse velocity test. The UPV is an excellent choice to assess the concrete homogeneity and quality. A more sophisticated tomography setup can be used to verify major voids and integrity issues in larger columns and piers. Together, a suite of properly selected NDT gadgets can help structural engineers enhance their engineering practice, reduce the guesswork, and minimize the amount of intrusive work. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have enjoyed this quick review. If you need more information, feel free to visit our website and YouTube channel for more educational materials. Have a wonderful day.